Hey, I'm Josh Clark, and this is Brain Stuff, and I've got an answer to a question that's probably in your head at all times. What exactly is the Joker card in a deck of cards for? I mean, think about it. If you lose the Joker, it doesn't affect any other kind of game. Crazy Eights, Old Maid, Goldfish, all of the important games. If you lose the Joker, who cares, right? Well, before we answer that question, consider this. The modern 52-card deck of playing cards that we play with and know and love today actually evolved from the old tarot decks. You got the Major Arcana, the Minor Arcana, minus the Knight cards, and you have our modern playing card deck. Somewhere around the 15th century, somebody took the tarot and converted it into playing cards and said, hey, let's play some poker. Now, it wasn't until about 1860 that the Joker first showed up. See, there's a game called Euchre, and it actually plays an important role. Under British rules of Euchre, there's a card called the Imperial Bower, or Bower.
Huh?
I don't know. And that's like the trump card. It's the one that you throw down, you're like, I win. Euchre's over, right? Eventually, the Imperial Bower, or Bower, morphed into the Joker we know and love today. That's where the Joker came from. If you like this video, there's plenty more where it came from all over this YouTube channel. Just go ahead and subscribe. Maybe leave a comment below, a nice one. Or just watch BrainStuff videos all day. No one's stopping you.